And greetings, hockey fans. Welcome to Buck Arena from Urbandale, Iowa, suburb of Des Moines, as the Des Moines Capitals are getting ready to play the rubber match against the Omaha Jr. Lancers. Good morning. This is Kevin Way, your play-by-play voice for the Des Moines Capitals this 2023-24 season. As we jokingly said this weekend, playing hurts. I'm not actually injured, but the vocal cords are not 100%. I'm fighting off a number of respiratory issues, so the pipes aren't, well, they're probably never golden. They're probably more like bronze most of the time. Now we're moving down from bronze to, just some like low level of steel. Not quite down to aluminum yet. Or certainly not down to talc or shale, thankfully. But we'll fight through as the Capitals do. And this morning's game, a victory is vital. It's not mathematically 100% a must win for the Capitals to keep their tournament hopes alive, but it's darn close. Capitals fell in a 3-2 shootout loss last night for senior night. Capitals, they looked good, just came out on the losing end, unfortunately. It gives the Capitals an 8-13-2-2 record with 25 games played, 7 games left in the season. If they were to win all 7, that'd give them 34 points. Already, Sioux City, Des Moines, Omaha, and Kansas City, the Des Moines Oakleys, all have 36 points or higher. Quad City has 32. They have 5 games left. Waterloo's played 25. They're at 29 points. Dubuque has 29 too, but they've also played 27 games. And then Mason City is holding down 8th. 25 games played. They have a 13-10-2-0 record. And it's going to be a chase for the Capitals to chase down Mason City. They're going to need some help. Now, Ames is ahead of the Capitals as well right now with an 11-2-1-1 record. Ames is just under 500 at a 481 percentage. Capitals are at 400. Cedar Rapids, while they have 10 games left, they're not entirely eliminated, but Cedar Rapids, Lincoln, and Fremont are essentially eliminated from playoff contention. Fremont is mathematically eliminated, and Lincoln will be with 8 games left. Can't come anywhere close to a 500 record. So for the Capitals, though, while they're not in a position to track down the Lancers, 2 points this morning is vital just to start. They're going to have to reel off a series of wins here late to get a little help with Mason City. Technically in win percentage, Dubuque is actually in 8th in win percentage at 537. So in some regards, the Capitals are kind of chasing down Dubuque. Between Dubuque and Mason City, I suppose. Either way, Capitals just need to tear off a series of wins and needs one of Dubuque or Mason City to just basically have the wheels fall off. Proud of for the Capitals is that Dubuque still has, they play Ames later today. They play Dubuque next weekend, and then they finish up with games against Cedar Rapids. So Dubuque has a, not an easy schedule, but it's a somewhat favorable schedule. Before we get too much further into things, we want to make sure we take some time to thank some of our sponsors this 30th anniversary season of the Capitals. Starting with Jen Stanbrough Real Estate. Thinking of buying or selling your home? Let Jen Stanbrough Real Estate help you. Jen has been a trusted broker in the Des Moines area since 2006 with expertise representing buyers, sellers, investors, builders, new construction, and executive estates. Should we get the graphic up for Jen Stample Real Estate? There we go. We clicked that. Yes, we had not. We also wish to thank the Goddard School of Waukee, the presenting sponsor of the first period. Through its inquiry-based learning approach and focus on social-emotional learning, the Goddard School is committed to creating a supportive and stimulating environment that fosters a lifelong love for learning and sets a solid foundation for students' future academic success. Call 515-297-6555 or go to goddardschool.com to learn more. All right, cut back to the live view here from Buck Arena. Teams have skated up onto the ice. See Gavin Flattery jump up onto the net. Depart from around Jackson Fleming. Go over the starters for Omaha, starting at defense, number 7, Chase Kirshner. Also number 75, Bryce Badura. Starting at center, number 31, Caden Allred. Also on the wing, number 93, Yano Anzalon. Also trying to make out the other starters, but not able to make that one out. Also starting in net for Omaha, number 18, Eli Samard. Samard in 13 games played, 597 minutes, 2 shutouts, 2.56 goals against average, 905 save percentage, and a 920-0 record. Starting for the Capitals this morning. At left defense, number 27, Mason Brooks. At right defense, number 14, Drake Ledinsky. Left wing, number 33, Gavin Flattery. At right wing, number 6, Ben Meline. Starting at center, number 15, Chase Stanbro. And then starting in nets, number 1, Jackson Fleming. We'll take a quick break during the playing of our national anthem here from Buck Arena. We'll join you for the drop of the puck as Midwest High School Hockey League action.
The advertisement's still up. Which one is
it? All right, so as the players put the buckets back on. See how much the Capitals can maintain the energy from last night's game and even the energy from this morning's JV game, which the JV team won 5-4 in a shootout. They relinquished the game tying goal with less than a minute left, but still managed to prevail in a win that's important for them. This game for the varsity team is significantly more important than their tournament hopes. Stambro will face off against Allred. We are underway from Des Moines. Face off one back by Stambro to Brooks. Brooks sends it up along the wall. Stopped by Kirshner. Kirshner, his pass intercepted by Stambro. Stambro fired just over the net. Puck comes right back towards near the slot. Dumped in by Allred. Nolan Fitzpatrick chasing for it. Hit by Brooks up the Flattery. Tried to move it up along the boards. Intercepted. Shot by Anzalon. Cleared out towards the point. Verdura with it. His pass tipped out of the zone. Allred back for it. Pass across to Verdura. Verdura looking to leave it. The old puck put towards the corner. Verdura bowls over Stambro. Pass intercepted momentarily by Logsdon, but Amzalon will get it. Moves it back to Verdura. Verdura trying to evade the forecheck of Logsdon. Logsdon almost had it poked away. It's knocked out to the neutral zone. Ladinsky will send it in. Gloved, dropped back down by some Eli Samard for Kirshner to start the breakout. Michael Chase into the zone. His shot directed away by Fleming. Second shot was deflected wide as Logsdon had lost his stick. Pass by Oliver Trushinski. Up towards, I believe that's Davis Martison with the send-in. Yep, number six. Pass towards the point, tip by Logsdon, shot from the point, glove by Fleming. Stopping play at the 1:37 mark. Faceoff will come to Fleming's right. Honecke will face off against Chase. And comes back to Chase. Chase shot save. Hit that quick shot by Chase. Hit Fleming in the chest. Thankfully he was reasonably centered to Chase on that one. Simply tried keeping in. Knocked out by the Lancers. Tip back to Chase. Chase driving wide. Backhand shot. Saved by Fleming. He quickly covers the rebound to freeze play again. This time at the 1:58 mark of the first. If you're just joining us and don't notice the graphic, it's still a scoreless tie here from Des Moines 0-0. Moulton wins the faceoff towards the wall. Myers pass out towards Campbell, connects. Campbell with the send-in, goes off the end boards. Parker will move it along the boards up for Parsons. And puck fed forward to Brooks Eiler. Eiler trying to work his way around Jones. Shot from the side of the net. Sent away, Crinklaw up to the point. Up to Parker. And hand pass, I think. Faceoff will come out. It's looking like the signals have sent it up to the neutral zone. It will be. This draw will come with 2:26 having elapsed off the clock. Faceoff won back by Crinklaw. Myers will play it at the blue line. Sent across that same blue line by Owen Pink. Gavin Gehringer will send it forward. Gehringer in for varsity this morning. slots in, and Grady Stiles played only the JV game today. Gehringer coming back from an upper body injury that he suffered over the break. Non-hockey related. The injury definitely affected his ability to play hockey. So Mayline pass too far forward for Stambro, and it will go for icing. Another defensive zone face-off. 255 mark. Capitals send up a couple of defensemen as Brooks and Ladinsky head back out after having started the game. Out there with that first line. Stambro wins the faceoff back. Ladinsky was trying to send it high off the glass, but went just over the glass, put it into the netting. So we'll have to do this all over again at the 259 mark. Stambro wins it back again. Ladinsky this time sends it around the boards towards Flattery. Flattery spins, sends it towards Stambro. Capitals can't get it out of the zone. Shot from the point, blockered away. Shot was by Parker, number 73, Sam Parker for the Lancers. Capitals get the puck out. Sam Parker skating back for it. Gets it in the corner, has the puck hop on him. Settles it, passes it over to Pink. Pink, pass intercepted. Logsdon, we've had a prime opportunity just to sling one towards the net. Stambro pass across. Logsdon catches an edge into the boards hard. He is not injured in that. Puck tipped into the zone at the red line by Stambro. Kirshner, long pass, tipped at the far blue line by Taylor Ross, number 34. That negated icing, allowed Ross to change up for the Lancers to finish the line change themselves. Reams with the puck, centered. Bartholomew was in too close on Samard to be a real option. Anzalon with the puck, shot saved, the rebound pops up front. Back to Anzalon, shot wide. So Anzalon, I guess, have to admit. Another shot directed away. That shot by Bedura. Point blank shot. Gloved out by Sharman. That was Allred with that shot. Cleared puck. Gets Patrick with it. He's pinned up along the boards by Sharman in the corner. Up towards Reams. Reams battling with Lundgren. Ferrari was trying to get it around Anzalon. And he'll come up to Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick with the send in. Lemmy takes it one in the chest, just freezes play. I was about to say, going over pronunciations with the Omaha coaching staff, I incorrectly assumed to be Anzalone. He's like, no. Nope. I wrote down my pronunciation correctly, it's Anzalon. And if I've been mispronouncing that all weekend, I'm sorry. Oh, Campbell bowls over Lundgren in the corner. Honeycutt will get it in the opposite corner, the treacherous Zamboni door corner, which helped the JV Capitals score their first goal of the game this morning as a wrap by Augustine popped out of the corner right out front. Goaltender Vincent D'Agosto had no clue it was even coming. That all packed and sacred. Push it home. Nice toe drag by Wagner. Wagner still with the puck. Moves it to the points. Krzyzewski skates in. Centers. Pass goes through the crease. Gehringer will pick it up. Dumps in the puck. Back to Lundgren. Lundgren has Wagner. He makes that pass. Wagner tries to send it across, but it's tipped. Now it's not back to the Capitals defensive zone. Send in by Ladinsky got tipped and went all over the place once it got to the Capitals offensive zone. Capitals strip parts of the puck. Meline shot blockered away by Simard, who you'll notice is a full righty. What does that mean? He catches right-handed. Shot. Score! Jace Danbro puts the Capitals on top with the goal from the slot at the 6:34 mark. Capitals varsity hasn't scored a lot of first goals lately. Well, they get one there, though. See if they can build on that. Yeah, Eli Simard, one of the few right catch goalies. Cool. Fleming's lost it! Cleared out. Brooks out there with the puck. Ladinsky pokes it away. Pass up to Meline. Meline feeds it forward to Stambro. Stambro puts it towards the slot. Parker with the wrap. Ladinsky lost an edge in the neutral zone. Eiler with it. Sharman drives him wide. Meline with it. Connection, a pass up to Flattery. Flattery gains the zone. Sends it in on Simard. They get picked up by Parker. Tries to net it high off the glass, but went over the glass by about 10 inches or so, sending it out of play. Generating an offensive zone faceoff for the Capitals at the 7:17 mark. Brooks Moulton on this faceoff. Towards the wing, Lancers will get it. Kirshner, the hard clear. Paxton in the race for the puck against Ryan Knapp. Rolling puck, sends it back. Picked up, pass up to Bedura at the point. Shot blockered away by Fleming. Moulton trying to get the clear, stopped along the wall by Ross. Moulton with it. Pass across toward Bartholomew, tipped in the zone, but sent right out by Kirshner. Capitals will flip it back in. Kirshner having tried to settle a rolling puck, sends it along the wall towards Knapp. Knapp's pass. Myers in the slot. Shot! Deflected over the net by the left-handed blocker of Simard. Attempted clear, hit the referee. So Kirshner back for it. Pass over to Ross. Ross connects on a pass up to Knapp. Knapp across the red line, set it in, and go for the line change. Erstad in on the forecheck. Jones couldn't get it around Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick sends a pass off the side of the net. Picked up by Logstad. Fitzpatrick strips him of the puck. Bowled over, now Angelon with it. He has it, his pass, his progress to the net blocked by Gehringer. And they got tabletopped. So Capitals, the puck, Simard will leave it. Barons will get there, sorry, Reams will get there first. Number 19, that's not a zero. Looked like a zero briefly, which is, I don't know if my mind did that, but thought about that quickly. I was like, wait a minute. Trzeszynski sends it along the board. Stopped by Ferrari, battling to try to get possession of the puck. Able to do so. Trzeszynski with it for the Lancers. Sends it in as Gehringer had stepped up in the neutral zone. Jones passes along the boards to Logsdon. Pass across. Reams chips it into the neutral zone. Shot back. Reams will get it. Reams will start to skid it out. He'll start to break out. Forward pass up towards Ferrari. Got tipped. That negates icing. Owen Pink will move it along the boards for Omaha. Angelon explodes into a big hit on Hunneke. Hunneke right back up, though. Lancers into the neutral zone. Chase, drop pass. Nice job by the Capitals to prevent Davis Martinson from getting a shot off. Point shot, got deflected up front. Towards the Broadlawn Medical Center board ad. Chase worked his way around Brooks. Pass up towards the point. Parker shot in on net. Rebound cleared out by Ladinsky. Now pass up to Landon Van Arum. Van Arum cuts towards center. Trying to chip it around Parker. Tripped up. Got back up quickly. Shot through the crease by Hunneke. Ladinsky with it towards the net. Deflected in it. I think it may have hit the post. Cleared up to the neutral zone. And we have not entirely certain what the call is. All I know is that the faceoff is coming in the offensive zone for the Capitals with 6:16 left here in the first. Capitals trying to extend a 1-0 lead. Vilaine gets the puck off the faceoff, sent it towards the slot, but it was cleared out by Parsons. And it'll go in on Fleming. So with a clear by Parsons, Parsons playing a little bit of billiards, sends it off the boards. In on Fleming for technically a shot on goal. And then gets the offensive zone faceoff. Stamberl faceoff against Krinklaw. Towards the wing. Safety moves it up to Flattery. Flattery chops it into the neutral zone, developing 2-on-1. Stamberl has Meline with him. Pass across, Meline. Fired shot into the logo of Simard. Luke Simard at 6'5", 205, one of the biggest goalies in the Midwest League. Shane Lochner for Waterloo, very tall as well, and weighs a fair amount more than Simard. Well, I think Simard maybe has 1 inch on him, or so on height. Oh, we have a penalty. Capitals to the hook. Yep. Holden Sharman will go to the sin bin for a hooking penalty at the 11-12 mark. That puts the Capitals onto the Jen Stambrow Real Estate penalty kill. And it's an important penalty kill. Capitals only up by one. They want to keep the Lancers down by one. That'll throw the puck off the faceoff. Push back to Eiler. Another pass to Krinklaw. Krinklaw's shot saved by Fleming. That shot did not go anywhere close to where I thought it was going when it came off his stick. Another shot, rebound, quickly covered by Fleming. Draw a pass up to the point. Shot deflected out front. Pink. Moves it to Krinklaw. Pass across to Eiler. Shot, rebound, deflects up into the netting and out of play. Face off one back by the Lancers. Pink with it. Dish over towards Eiler. Eiler from the faceoff circle. Shot saved by Fleming. Couple Capitals fans accusing Cody Parsons of trying to win a daytime Emmy. And caught that one on the area mic. That's not exactly the way they said it, but anyways. So Eiler passed towards Krinklaw. Krinklaw shot blocked. Another shot quickly blocked away by Fleming. Up towards Eiler. Fired. That one got deflected. Hit Ladinsky. Backhander shot, and Fleming is on it. Parsons with the shot that Fleming landed on, thankfully. So 52 seconds left on the hooking penalty to Sharman. Sharman Jace Stambler will take his face off against Caden Allred shortly. As Michael Chase takes his spot at the point. Pass back to Lundgren. And to Chase, Chase from the faceoff circle. As Richter goes high, kept in by Lundgren at the point. And now cleared, tipped by Stambro. Chase hustles back to a rolling puck. Still rolling on him. Chip towards the wall. Logsdon tries to hit it in, but he hits Stambro. Now dumped in by Allred. Wagner will get the puck for the Lancers. Pass up to Lundgren. Lundgren dish over towards Chase. Chase pass towards the far side. Attempted shot to Martinson. I think he hit the side of the net with his shot. Pass towards Chase again. Shot got deflected away. He kept it at the point by Lundgren. Capitals are back at full strength. Shot. Rebound! And it's covered by Fleming. So Capitals kill off the penalty to Sharman. Get the defensive zone faceoff with 3:41 left. And now with five men aside, we'll hope to possess the puck a little more and get it back into the offensive zone. In a game that otherwise is moving fairly quickly. Off the draw. Lancers will get the puck. Myers. Thought he cleared it up, but not quite. Shot by Ross, saved by Fleming. Back up along the wall, up to Bedura. Bedura, his shot through traffic, goes wide. Kirshner sends it towards the corner. Now Brooks with it, sends it around the boards, up towards Campbell. Campbell, trying to get in a clear, kept in by Kirshner. His shot blocked, another shot by Kirshner, towards the slot. Shot over the net as Brooks pulled over Knapp. No, sorry, that was Erstad, not Knapp. Similar height. They both shoot right, too, so I'm not completely So Myers gets to a puck. Pushed over towards Brooks. Brooks up towards Ferrari. Not towards the wing. Ferrari gets it. Trying to work his way around Kirshner. Kirshner did a good job of angling him towards the boards and separating him from the puck. So Bedura wraps it around towards Ross. Ross opens up. Trying to shield the puck from Campbell. Pass toward Knapp. Now Ross will flip it into the zone. Back to Sharman. Sharman passes it up to Ferrari. Ferrari with the send-in. But he was just beyond the center red line. That causes icing to be called. We'll move the puck down into the Capitals defensive zone for the faceoff with 2:20 left. Capitals still up 1-0. Trying to protect their lead. Omaha's gotten a lot of shots off here. Second half of the first period. Pass up towards Pink. Back towards Angelon. Chips. It's loose out front. Up to Ferrari. Ferrari pass over to Logsdon. Logsdon works his way around Parker. Tried centering it. Got blocked. Range with it. Went beyond the blue line. Capitals will have to tag up. That's going to give Caden Allred some space to work with. Pass up to Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick with the send-in. Stuck by Fleming using the blade of his stick and covered for another stoppage of play with 1:48 remaining in the first. Stambro to face off against Allred. Stambro wins it back towards Jones. Jones kicks it along the glass, batted out of midair by Anzalon and put in towards the corner. Jones back along the wall. Comes out to Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick checks it in the backhander towards the slot. Goes tipped by Gehringer. Gehringer just missed Meline with the pass. Lancers ended up sending that one in just beyond the red line. Generating an icing call in the Capitals' favor. Give them an offensive zone draw. 1:27 left. This offensive zone draw could be a prime opportunity for the Capitals to add an insurance tally. Stanley will leads off against Allred. Flannery will get the puck. Wrapped it off the glass, and it went out of play. The faceoff will come up to the neutral zone. Puck one way back. Standler. Jones will get it. Board pass over to Gehringer. Long pass. Intercepted. It's Patrick with that interception. Already with it. Tried centering. Going towards the wall. Parker reaches back. Keeps it in. Gets it to Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick stripped of the puck. Capitals lose it though. Shot scored. Nolan Fitzpatrick with the shot from near the faceoff dot. Evens it with 54.1 left as the Capitals just couldn't get the puck out. It looked like they were about to, but I think some miscommunication between Melin and Stambro caused them to lose possession of the puck, and Fitzpatrick quickly gets it thereafter and rifles a shot that twitches the twine and ties things up at the 16:05 mark. Hunnicky on the draw against Crinklaw. Battle for the puck. Puck kicked over towards the wall. Van Arum will get there. Puck cleared by Lundgren. Pass it towards Crinklaw. Crinklaw pokes it in. Fleming with the cover. We'll see if... Looks like Ledinsky... Crinklaw to the box for a penalty. Cross check. Michael Chase, the captain, looking for an explanation from the referee as to why Ledinsky didn't get a penalty. Stambro now there as well to listen in on behalf of the Capitals. What we know is that the Capitals will go on to the Chen Stambro Real Estate Power Play. 39.8 seconds left in the first. See if they can score a go-ahead goal here late in the first. Sharman with the puck. Fans on the pass. Pass over towards Stambro. Now to Reams. Back to Stambro. Back to Reams. Reams shot blocked. Kept at the point by Stambro. Quick feed over to Reams. Back to Stambro. Sharman. Sharman launches one towards the net. Simard with the save. So another faceoff now with 12.2 seconds left. Stambro wins it back to Sharman. Sharman pass to Ferrari. Ferrari pass across, connects with Reams. Swords to net. Flattery shot saved by Simar. Try jamming at it. And we'll get a face-off with 0.3 seconds left. I would have a righty take this face-off and just shoot it. And yep, they're going to put Ferrari in. And well played by Eiler. He knew what was coming. He just drops for a shot block. So after one, Capitals and the Lancers are tied at one. Capitals will start the second period on the power play with 1:21 left on the cross check assessed to Magnus Crinklaw. So we'll take a break during this first intermission. Back for the drop of the puck for the second period. This is Kevin Wayne for Capitals Hockey. You're watching the Capitals on YouTube. And we welcome you back here from Buck Arena. The Capitals and the Lancers tied 1-1 after one. And just a few minutes away from the drop of the puck in the second period. When we get to that puck drop in the second period, we want to take some time to thank a couple of our sponsors. Starting with Stanbro Realty. Stanbro Realty Company is a full-service real estate firm in Central Iowa with commercial brokerage, developing commercial property management, including homeowners association management, and property development services as well. And that is Stanbro Realty. Capitals also wish to thank the presenting sponsor for the second period, but that's Home Solutions of Iowa. Home Solutions of Iowa is a full-service exterior remodeling company serving all of Iowa. They are the leading home improvement contractor when it comes to gutter systems, roofing, insulation, rain barrels, windows, doors, decking, and siding. And that is Home Solutions of Iowa. And as we cut back to the live view here from Buckner, we want to mention that we learned during the intermission that at the varsity level, earlier today and last night, that the number 37 again, for the varsity games is not Magnus Crinklaw. It is Josiah Roby wearing Crinklaw's jersey, which I kind of became suspicious about it. I didn't notice it during the JV game last night. Then during varsity, I noticed that Crinklaw had, who I thought was maybe Crinklaw based on the jersey, had much darker skin than I remember my son having played against him at younger age groups. So I was kind of like, maybe I just never noticed. But after watching Crinklaw again this morning with less melanin and watching the varsity game, I'm like, all right, this is not the same player. And sure enough, my suspicion was confirmed that is in fact Josiah Roby. Now I just have to make sure that when I see the 37, that is, I say Josiah Roby. So it's Roby who's in the penalty box for 121 to start the second period. Power play is a prime opportunity for the Capitals to add a go-ahead goal. It's a win in regulation. Very helpful. Just avoid the stress of the shootout altogether. Officials have made their way back out to the ice surface. And now the Capitals start to skate out as well. Capitals do have, it's probably become evident, but Capitals do have Brooks Moulton back. He was out last night with a upper body injury for precautionary reasons, but deemed good to go for today's game, which is important. He's one of the Capitals' top penalty killers. hopefully the Capitals don't end up needing the penalty kill too much this morning, soon to be afternoon. But if they do, having Moulton out there, it would be helpful. Roby makes his way back across to the penalty box. Stambler will take this faceoff. He's out with Flattery, Ferrari, Reams, and Charmin for this power play. Allred will take the faceoff for the Lancers. The wing. Flattery will knock it back to Charmin. Charmin pass over towards Reams. Reams back to Stambro. Stambro around one. Toe drags on another. Pass over to Reams. Reams rounds the net. Pass up towards Charmin. Charmin through Reams' legs over to Stambro. Stambro shot blocked. Flattery battling with Lundgren to get there. Captain at the point. Stambro across to Charmin. Back to Stambro. Fish to Reams. Back to Stambro. Off the half wall. Pass to the bumper. Ferrari misfire. Sends it wide. Healed that one. Fleming will come out. Pass intercepted by Eiler. Reams will dish it back to Ferrari. Ferrari builds deep from behind the net. Through the neutral zone. Ferrari, once he builds his speed, is one of the fastest players in the entire league. Reams shot blocked to the point to Stambro. Stambro winds up, slaps one in on Simard. Simard makes the stop near the collarbone, but covers the rebound to freeze play. With 6 seconds left on the penalty to Roby. Offensive zone face-off for the Capitals at the 1:15 mark. Up to the point. Back to Reams. Rangers are back at full strength. Reams pass goes through the slot. Sent in by Charmin. Tipped into the corner. Parker pokes it in the opposite corner. Reams will get to it. Pass picked off by Erstad. Headed pass for Knapp. Picked off. Ferrari with it. Pass to Stambro. Stambro with the send in. Van Arum in on the forecheck. Capitals work to get two defensemen out. Do so. Ross chips the puck around Ferrari. And behind the net. Tried centering. Blocked by Ferrari. Ferrari chops it towards the wall, and it'll make its way out. Happened to roll over the blade, or past the blade of Owen Pink. Brooks connects under pass at center towards Hunneke. Back towards Hunneke. Now Brooks with it. Brooks through the defense. Skates in. Shot! I think Samard got a piece of that with the glove, but it went off and out of play. So Hunnekill take the faceoff, flanked by Bartholomew and Van Arum. Brooks and Ledinski out. Kirshner looking to clear it. Captain at the blue line by Ledinski. Bartholomew trying to get a shot off, unable to do so. That's... oh, wow. Bartholomew with a cross check to the back of Ross that sent him into the boards head first. No penalty. That's, Capitals got very lucky there. Now we have a penalty. Ryan Knapp shaking a bit up behind the play. Landon Van Arum will go to the penalty box at the 3 minute mark. 2 minutes. Oh, checking from behind. Checking from behind routinely comes with a 10 minutes. So we'll see if someone has to go serve the minor. And it looks like it's going to be Trevor Bartholomew. So the Capitals will be without Landon Van Arum for a while. Most of this period. 14 minutes left. No earlier than the 2 minutes left that the Capitals will get him back. So Capitals on to the Jens Stambro real estate penalty kill. All red shot save. Nice job by Fleming to stay square from that angle. That shot deflected. Jones got a piece of that shot by Martinson. Allred with the puck, circles back into the corner. Holds up, passes up to the point, shot by Chase. Moulton blocked that one. Took that one in the foot. Capitals will get Stambro in, shot through traffic, save. Good time for Fleming to give up no rebound and freeze the play as Stambro is coming in to join the penalty kill unit as Moulton took that one in the foot. So Stambro on the draw. Moves it back towards Brooks. Brooks shovels it out on the backhand. Trashinsky with the puck. Pass over towards Chase. Chase evades Stambro, who loses his stick. Chase towards the slot. Puck poked away by Fleming. Wasn't going to be a shot on net. Dump puck. Samard will come out. Moves it over towards Allred. Stambro will get it. Spins. Pass over towards Logsdon. Logsdon's in there, the boards hard. Brooks will set it in on the backhand. Pass up to Wagner. Wagner into the neutral zone. Chips it forward. Brooks in a race against Parsons. Brings it back around. Kept in. Roby tried centering it. Logs got that block. Took a hard hit from Parsons, but gets the clear. Samard will leave it. And we have got a penalty. Looks like Davis Martinson. And a 10. So Martinson. Has some sort of minor penalty here at the 4:55 mark. Whatever that minor penalty is going to be served. By Ryan Knapp. So it won't be until the very end of the period that Martinson exits the penalty box. It's only 5 seconds until Bartholomew will finish serving the minor penalty against Van Arum. Van Arum has his own 10-minute misconduct in the serving. Clean faceoff win by Stambro. Stambro with the puck. Needs it pulled up towards Sharman. Sharman holds up along the half wall. Omaha able to clear it. Pass towards the slot. Rames will get it. Reams chips it up towards Stambro. Stambro with the block. Board pass over towards Reams. Reams fires, shot saved by Samard, and he draws it in and covers. Face off Against the wall, Ferrari up to Reams. Pass over towards Stambro. Pass down to Ferrari. Ferrari from behind the nets. Up to Charmin. Across to Stambro. Stambro from the faceoff circle. Trying to connect and a pass over to Ferrari. Goes through the slot. Charmin will get it. Shot towards the net. Simard will get the save. No rebound. .102 left on this power play for the Capitals. Stampa will face off against Allred. Tips it back to Charmin. Can't keep it in the zone though. Challenged by Josiah Roby. Roby passes back to Trushinski. Trushinski chips it in. Fleming comes out. Sends it around the boards. Ferrari with it. Ferrari picks up some speed. Mishandles, turns it over to Roby. He loses the handle. Stambro gets it back, goes it back to Ferrari. Ferrari passes over to Flattery. Flattery with the wrap. And Ferrari. Ferrari quickly engaged by Roby. Just in the corner to Flattery. Flattery up towards the point. Kept in by Stambro. Pass to Reams. Reams back to Stambro. Back to Reams. Reams. Circles back. Pass over to Stambro. Stambro dishes to Charmin. Penalty expires. Long dump goes in on Fleming. Fleming clears it. Ferrari unable to control the puck. Allred regroups. Pass up toward Roby and missed him and goes for icing. So Capitals fail to score with the man advantage. Still tied 1-1 at the 7:13 mark of the second. Hunneke will take this faceoff against Erstad. Manages to get it, tend to clear, blocked by Myers. Erstad with the puck, Myers diving to try to get it on the back check. Erstad works his way around Ledinski towards the net. Shot over the cage and out of play. And the faceoff will be coming out to the neutral zone. Hunneke wins it back to Ledinski. He passed to Brooks. Brooks feeds it forward to Bartholomew at the red line. With a Hunneke. Capitals tag up. Hunneke trying to fish the puck out. Did so, but had it poked away by Allred. Brooks pass could not be controlled by Myers. Shot from the distance. Over the net. Hunneke pass towards Myers as he tried to cut through. As Bartholomew crashes into a couple of Lancers. Anzalone's playing physical. Myers dished towards Bartholomew, but the pass is behind him. Anzalone's shot set wide. Brooks, hard board pass up towards Hunneke. Tipped by Bartholomew. Bartholomew with the dump in, and he'll go for the line change. Simard leaves the puck for Parker. Parker pass to the right wing. Turnover. Capitals have to tag up though. Moulton's back out there, which is good to see. Sends it in on Simard. He'll glove it down. Leaves it to Parker. Parker clear along the boards, but stopped by Logsdon. Logsdon's pass towards Moulton. Tipped out of the zone. Anzalone gets the penalty. Anzalone offered interference. Called at the 58-57 mark. Capitals back onto the chin. Stambro, real estate power play. Stambro wins it back to Logsdon. To Sacre. Back to the old school power play. Sacre and Brooks. Brooks shot towards the net. Rebound. Another penalty on Omaha. To Brooks. Brooks fires. Shot wide. So penalty on Sam Parker. Cross check at the 9:23 mark. Capitals would have probably have been wise to have just maybe given Omaha the puck to have more time set up with a 5-on-3 advantage. 5-on-3 is easier to work than 6-on-4, in my opinion at least. Pass across, looking for a one-timer to Ferrari. Missed. Cleared out. Goes in on Fleming. Fleming passes it up to Brooks. Brooks holds up. Pass to Meline. Meline can't handle it. Locked it. It'll keep it. Allred with the puck. Shot scores. Allred with the shorthanded goal. 5-on-3 shorthanded goal. Takes a special power play unit to give up a 5-on-3 power play goal. Lancers up 2-1 at the 9:53 mark. Capitals have 1:04 left. So Ferrari with the puck. So Allred unassisted. Ferrari dishes back to Stambro. Up to Reams. Pass over to Sharman. Had to pass through the slot. Tipped. Back to Reams. Reams shot. Blocked and out of play. The Lancers win the faceoff. Attempted clear, blocked. Sharman with the puck at the point now. Pass to Reams. Reams over to Ferrari. Cross to Sharman. Lobbed one-timer off the toe. And Sharman shot glove saved by Samard. Up one back. 24 seconds left on the power play. Reams shot blocked. Reams with the stop at the point. Flattery passed down to Stambro, back to Flattery. Across to Sharman. Over to Reams. Stambro shot through traffic, deflected wide. Omaha back at full strength. Flattery shot blocked. Cleared up to the neutral zone. So the Capitals fail to score on the power play and give up a shorty. Shot hits the side of the net. Parsons' stick has broken on him. Flattery with the puck. Skates tried to spin the defense. Shot deflected into the corner. Shot from a sharp angle by Ferrari. Set away. Pass up to Anzalon. Anzalon. Gets it into the zone. Logged in. Tried sending it around. Up to the point. Kirshner. Shot blocked. Goes wide. Back to Kirshner at the point. Pass across to Tuschinski. Tuschinski off the shot. Pad save. Sent towards the half wall. Reams upended. We'll get cleared. Stambrill racing against Anzalon. Moves up along the wall. Kirshner. Right, clearing it off the boards. I think Stambrill got a piece of it, sent it into the Capitals bench. Just win that faceoff. Onside, Meline, short dish over to Logsdon. Logsdon with the send in. Samard will come out. He's a professional. Kirshner is on the boards. Hunneke, Meline, shot blocked. Meline with the wrap towards the opposite corner. Logsdon will get it. Separated from the puck by Badura. Knapp evades. Brooks sends the puck forward up to Ross. Shot save. Locked him with the puck into the neutral zone. Kicks it back to his blade. Hunneke, oh, has it poked away. Puck cleared off the glass by Lancers up towards Ross. Ladinsky with it. Sent into the boards by Ross. Ladinsky merges with the puck still though. Clears it. Puck was tipped by a Lancer. That'll be icing. Myers came in kamikaze style on the forecheck. Meline evades. Shot! Score! Ben Meline ties it. Goal scored by Meline at 14:03 mark. Big goal. See if the Capitals can maintain this energy. The Lancers get the puck off the faceoff. And Meline unassisted. Oh, pass out. Fanned by Fitzpatrick. He's already scored once for the Lancers this morning. Earlier this morning, now this afternoon. Today. Centering attempt. Pink. Through the crease, up to Pink. In the corner, looking to feed Fitzpatrick again. Capitals will clear it. And icing. Off one by the Lancers. Wagner's shot blocked. Jones with it. Clears it. Chases. Harder than he'd hoped it would. And it goes for Icy. Stammer on the faceoff of the Capitals, wins it towards the corner. Jones chips it off the glass. Bouncing puck will get picked up by Chase. Chase to Wagner at the blue line, who tips it into the corner. It's Patrick with it, wraps it around the boards. Gehringer will get it. Engaged by Wagner. Now up to Meline. Meline through the triangle. And to Flattery. Flattery shot tipped and went wide. Back to Flattery again. Spins. Pad save. Pink circles away from Stambro. Pass up to Chase. Chase shot. Save. Rebounds. Cleared out by Gehringer. Stambro will get the puck. Chips it off the glass and out. Krasinski back for it. Lundgren tipped in on net. Left for Brooks. Brooks stripped of the puck. Roby tried centering it. Went through the slot. Clear. And then will leave the zone. Chip by Lockton is trying to connect with Reams. Speed work by Eilert. He has the puck poked away by Lockton. Pass over now to Allred. Allred. Shot save. Swept out by Brooks. Reams with it. Passes over towards Stambro. And offside. Logsdon, Ferrari, Reams. Good block by Logsdon on the clear, attempted clear. Krasinski. Passes back over to Lundgren. Lundgren has to plug the wall to Roby. Roby pass towards Eiler. Eiler dumps it in. Allred will get there. Sends it into the corner. Roby hustling to the puck. Sends a pass back over towards Allred. Allred now behind the net. Centers. And time expires before Krasinski can fire it. And after a disappointing shorthanded goal allowed, 5-on-3 power play, Caden Allred scores the shorty. But Ben Meline ties it up with the goal. Not late in the second, but later in the second. Tie things back up at 34 minutes of play. So again, we'll take another break. This second and final resurface. I don't want to say the final intermission because it is technically a brief intermission between regulation and overtime, if that is necessary. We shall see. Alright, well, we'll be back in about 9.5 or so minutes. We'll drop the puck for the third period to thank some sponsors. Get ready for the action here from Buck Arena as the Capitals suit to pick up a vital victory. Lancers, the Capitals try to keep their Midwest High School Hockey League tournament hopes alive. And we rejoin you here from Buck Arena. Just under 5 minutes left until the drop of the puck for the third period. The Capitals tied against the Lancers 2-2 after two. The goal just over 2.5 minutes left by Ben Meline. Before we go too much further, I'm going to take time for our final break. Thank some sponsors. Starting with Nucor Harris Rebar. Nucor Harris Rebar, located in Newton, Iowa, is the Midwest's largest fabricator of concrete reinforcing bars. For more information, please visit Nucor Harris Rebar's website at harrisrebar.com. And you can check out their wordmark on the front of the jerseys of the National Hockey League's Carolina Hurricanes. Also, thanks to Waukee Wellness and Chiropractic. Dr. Wes at Waukee Wellness and Chiropractic has been helping athletes of all ages and abilities since 2007. Research shows athletes under chiropractic care can reduce the chance of injuries and, if injured, get you back in the game quicker. Call Dr. Wes at 515-978-6661 or visit waukeewellness.com to see how he can help you. Also, thanks to our third presenting sponsor of this third period, along with Nicker Harris Rebar and Walking Walls and Chiropractic, is Concrete Connection. Concrete Connection is a full-service concrete contractor servicing all of Central Iowa since 2010. Concrete Connection offers a wide variety of services from large commercial projects to residential driveway replacement. Concrete Connection's track record of excellence assures you that your project will be on time and on budget. Call Bart at 515-202-1279 or go to www.yourconcreteconnection.com. Your connection to perfection. Capitals also want to thank Des Moines University Clinic Physical Therapy for their support this season, as well as the Hockey Shop, formerly known as JT Slapshot, purchased recently by Pure Hockey. With high hopes that not too much changes. We shall see. And either way, we thank JT's for their support of Cyclones Hockey. Well, that too, actually, a little bit. But of Capitals Hockey this season and seasons previous, and their support of the Des Moines Youth Hockey Association and all associations throughout Iowa. This will take time for us to know what all changes could be in store with Pure Hockey's purchase of Slapshot. Do you know that they do have nice new polos and quarter zips, which look very sharp? The officials skate back out onto the ice, as do the Capitals, eager to pull back ahead. Testing out his blades once we got a sharpening during the intermission. Mm-hmm. One more full period of hockey here at home for the Capitals this 2023-24 season. After today, the rest of the season is on the road. And they start a needed win streak here today with a victory over the Omaha Jr. Lancers. We will find out in just about half an hour. Stambro will take the opening draw this period, as he routinely does. Let's see if Caden, well, it looks like it will be Caden Allred taking the faceoff for the Lancers. Faceoff comes back to Brooks. Brooks up towards Flattery. He's taken off the puck, but Stambro will get it passed towards Meline. Shift around Ledinsky. Brooks will get to it. Hard wrap. Stopped by Stambro. Evades Allred. Pass up towards Flattery. Flattery with the puck. Backhander towards the net. Moves. Grenades a little bit on Simard. Now shot by Meline towards the net. Gloved by Simard. Stopping play at the 32-second mark. Lancers will choose to change up their personnel. Looks like the Capitals will keep who they have. Looks like Michael Chase will take this face off against Stambro for the Lancers. Towards the wing. Puck knocked by Meline. Now Stambro trying to get it. Chip back towards Flattery. Chase will get it. Good speed behind the net. Chip towards Parsons, set back by Brooks. Backhander sent in on net by Stambro from beyond the blue line. Wagner hounded. Evade Stambro and Meline. Board pass forward. It's gone wide of Fleming, but he chose to stop it with the stick and cover it. Generates a defensive zone faceoff for Des Moines at the 107 mark. Ferrari on the faceoff against Chase. His puck shot, save! Chase with that shot up front. Reams will dump it in. It's just wide of the net. Puck will clear out. A little bit of a tipped. Parsons in hard. Sharman with the puck. Long pass behind Reams. This will go for pinball's in on net. Reams shot. Loxton pass up front. Puck moved over to Ross. Ross it to the neutral zone towards Eiler, but he has it poked away by Sharman. Now Josiah Roby will get it back for the Lancers. He stripped of the puck. Ferrari over to Van Arum. Van Arum holds up. Driving the slot. Shot. Just wide. Logsdon tried centering. And getting deflected behind the net. Up to Jones. Jones sends it around the wall. Ventura drags the puck through the legs of Logsdon. Oh, strange bounce out of that Zamboni door corner. Tipped by Logsdon toward Ferrari, but out of his reach. And the Lancers will clear it. Gehringer to Jones. Jones tried clearing it, but a stop by Roby. Roby's shot blocked. Gehringer sends Ross into the boards. Oh, Ferrari, turnover, shot, save. Pop fly comes up to the point to Kirshner. Shot wide far side. Bartholomew clears it out. Kirshner with the puck. After the neutral zone, stopped by Hunneke. Hunneke trying to deal with a bouncing puck. Shot over the net. And it's just cleared out to Ledinsky. Ledinsky passes it across to Brooks. Brooks sends a roller that's intercepted by Ross. Ross shot save. And Aram sends it off the glass. Kept it at the point. Now Knapp shot deflected high. That move goes high off the glass. Thought it might go out of play, but it did not. Knapp pass over to Parker. Parker diagonal pass across to Erstad. Erstad feeds it forward towards Knapp, but misses him. Brooks gains the zone. Shot from a distance. Blocker over the net. Brooks out of the corner. Pass off the side. Ledinsky fires one. Deflected. Loose up front. Cleared. Nice pass off pad by Brooks. From the goal line. Puts it off Samard's pad. That sends it all the way up to Ledinsky at the point. Knapp looks at that offensive zone. Face off at the 3:53 mark. Moulton will take this draw for Des Moines. Nice clear back towards Campbell. But cleared up by Knapp. Shining with the puck. Pass tipped by Myers. Set back in by Parker. Safety will stop it. Saucer towards Moulton. Tip forward. Back towards the neutral zone. Puck batted down by Moulton. Moulton will send it in. Samard will leave it for Parker. Parker passed the paint. A lot of plosives on that line. Shot by Chase goes wide. Safe with the puck for the Capitals. Long saucer. Onto the blade of Campbell, but he was not able to control it. Pass back towards Trushinski, just misses him. Stambrill with it. Shot. Save. Capitals with another offensive zone draw. This one at the 4:56 mark. Clear, captain at the point by Jones. Jones will dump it into the corner. Pass back up along the wall. Right back, Trushinski, short dish. Pass up to Anzala. Anzala holds up. Passes over towards Lundgren. Lundgren skates it into the zone. Towards the net. Poked by Gehringer. Up to the point. One-timer shot. Pinball. That's deflected. Catch a leg drag. Gehringer will get the puck. Skated it into the neutral zone. Shot. Uses the Trushinski as a screen. Samard made the save. Penalty. Cross-check on Anzalon, assessed at the 5:56 mark. Capitals back onto the Jen Stambrill Real Estate Power Play. Hopefully this one goes better than the last one. Off the draw, but not towards the end boards. Flattery, there's the body on Parker, and Lancers will get the clear. Fleming leaves it for Reams. Reams sends a pass back towards the corner to Ferrari. Ferrari pass to Stanbro. Saucer up towards Ferrari. Puck dies at the blue line, though. It's just never what you want. Stambro misses the puck. Wagner circles back. Shovels it in on the backhand. Parsons. Set into the boards. On the poke by Fleming. Stambrell, drop pass to Charmin. Charmin across to Ferrari. Ferrari shot save, rebound! Glove save by Samard. Reeves with the shot. Samard flashes the leather, although the gloves aren't helping me with the leather anymore, but you all know what I mean. Van Arum on the face-off. Tip by Brooks. Saturday attempt. Cleared. Josiah Roby. Lot of speed towards the net. Separated from the puck. Logs will get it from behind the net. Pass back to Sakri. Sakri dishes back to Brooks. Brooks leaves it forward up to Sakri. Sakri pass across to Meline. Now pass over to Van Arum. Towards the net, shot, rebound, too far out of the reach of Meline and cleared. Fleming feeds it up to Brooks. Brooks circles back. 15 seconds left on the power play. Logsdon through the neutral zone. Pass over towards Sakri. Sakri, shot blocked. Cleared. Sakri's going to have to hustle. He's in a race against Eiler. And Sakri is going to get a holding penalty. So Sakri assessed the penalty at the 9:02 mark. Capitals on to the Jan Stambrell Real Estate penalty kill. They'll send out Moulton, Jones, Charmin, and Campbell. Lanter send out Allred, Trashinsky, Lundgren, Wagner, and Chase. Campbell on the draw. Wagner will get it. Pass intercepted. Campbell can't get it out, though. Shot scored. Chase. Sharp shoots one from the faceoff circle. Power play goal scored by Chase at the 8:11 mark. Make the Capitals pay that little extra action for that retaliation. Causes a penalty, which generates a power play goal against. Bartholomew can't get the shot off. Hunter gets to the puck. Bartholomew, but shot, rebound, chipped! Just wide, Hunter with that shot. Nap. Along the boards, up to Ligonski at the point. Shot, gloved by Samard. So 8:05 left in regulation. Capitals need to tie this one back up. As before, they all basically have to win out starting today to make the Midwest League tournament. Off the draw, Pink pass up along the boards to Allred. Allred's up towards Fitzpatrick. Fitzpatrick shoots it down low. Brooks loses the battle behind the net. Anzalone with it, spin, shot blocked. Meline down the right wing. Cuts towards center, taken down. Brooks gets it just beyond the blue line. Pass to Flattery. Flattery not able to maintain control of the puck. Brooks forward up to Stambrough. Stambrough driving the slot. Has it poked away, though. Gets it back. Knocks it into the corner. Meline will get there. Pass back towards Stambrough. Backhand shot blocked. Allred wrapped it around the opposite direction. Logson will get the puck. Knocks it back towards Logson again. Reverse back up the boards to Ladinsky. Full hard slapper. Gehringer's shot misses the net. Pass to Stambrough. Shot save. That slapper by Ladinsky had to be close to 90 miles an hour. Would love to see him unleash that cannon way more often. Let's just get the puck off the faceoff. Gehringer moves up to Reams. Now London with it. Along the wall. Pass, turnover to Logsdon. Logsdon. Chop through traffic, Samard with the save. Logsdon will generate an offensive zone faceoff though with 6:37 left in the third. Logsdon spins, shot blocked by Lundgren. Eiler manages to get the puck up to Roby. Roby fires the pass across to Trushinski. Trushinski has it poked away by Ferrari. Shot by Parsons from the point, got deflected well wide. Parsons shot, save. Ferrari pass across to Logsdon, connects. Logsdon trying to connect on the pass towards Ferrari. Sacre comes in. Managed to keep it onside. Shot by Reams. Deflected off of Samard's shoulder and out. That'll generate an offensive zone faceoff with 5:54 left. The Sacre. Sacre shot blocked. Kirshner sends it around the boards up towards Wagner. Wagner dishes it back. Developing 2-on-1. Shot wide. Kirshner gets it. Pass across to Wagner. Wagner forward connects with Chase. Chase shot saved by Fleming. Meline gets it to Stambrough. Stambrough over towards Flattery. Flattery sends it in, deflects off a Lancer and in. Pass over to Badura. Badura's long pass poked away by Campbell, but the Lancers quickly get it back. Wagner slips the check of Campbell. Shot by Chase off of Fleming's shoulder. Campbell, all turnover right to Badura. Wagner holds up at the blue line, dishes it to Ross. Ross towards center. Cleared out by Brooks. Brooks, hard pass over to Myers. Myers can't get it through Pink. Now Campbell sends it over towards Moulton. Moulton trying to handle a rolling puck. Chip. Ladinsky keeps it at the point. Dumps in. Brooks with it, hard pass. Takes out the butt end of the stick line there. Myers to the loose puck. Shot wide, short side. Moulton is going to come up to Gehringer. Gehringer fires it towards the net, directed away by Samard. Gehringer again, this shot goes through the crease, and it's cleared out. Levinsky pass over towards Gehringer, tipped into the zone. Gehringer fights through the check. Pass up to Myers, shot! Save! Wrapped up along the boards. Jones will keep it in. And long clear. Face off with 3:25 left. Hunneke on the draw for the Capitals against Roby. Shot, oh, got deflected wide. Center attempt, shot by Hunneke wide. Anzalone will get it for the Lancers. Shifted into the neutral zone. Cuts wide, shot blocker, rebound. Another save. Bartholomew passed too far forward for Van Arum. Ranger separates Anzalone from the puck. Fitzpatrick with the send-in. Jones will get it. Clears. It's going to go for icing. 2:37 left. Capitals still in need of a goal here to tie it back up to at least send it to overtime. It's up, one back. It's Patrick with it. Sends a puck off the end boards. Roby trying to drive towards the slot. Anzalone shot directed away by Fleming. Roby hustles through to the puck. There's Patrick with it. Centered. Shot side of the net. Anzalone will get the rebound. Shot off the skate of Brooks. Pass towards the slot. Centered, shot by Anzalone, save. Brooks with the puck. Ferrari drop pass to Ferrari. Ferrari still with it. Check from behind. Josiah Roby will get the penalty. Roughing on Josiah Roby with 1:48 left. Fleming stays in the net. It might not be long until the Capitals take him off for the extra attacker. It's Stambrough with Logsdon, Ferrari, Reams, and Sharman. Timeout. Capitals. Capitals will have some time to think about this one. See if they... Yeah, first thing, Tony Wiles talking to Jackson of Fleming about looking for them to come to the bench. The buzzer sounds. Fleming is way up by the hash marks. mark, working his way back into the net for Omaha. Stambro will be on the draw against Allred. One back to Charmin. Fleming to the box, to the bench with 1:43 left. Reams, fans, shot. All went just wide. Ferrari pass along the wall. Up to Stambro, to Reams. Winds up, shot, blocked. Fleming shot saved by Simard. Flattery up to Reams, out to Stambro, fakes the shot. Blocked, cleared. Empty netter. I think that was Caden Allred with the empty netter. Scored at the 15:50 mark. Stambro wins it back to Ladinsky. Pass up to Meline. Meline shields it from Eiler. Fleming back off again with 57 seconds left. Another clear. Reams will get it. Pass to Logsdon. Logsdon to Reams. Back to Stambro. Shot deflected. Turnover and cleared. Pass over to Meline. Drop pass back to Reams. Reams shot blocked. Logsdon back for it. Capitals begin their shots blocked a lot. Eiler shot stopped by Stambro. Stambro, another shot block. Jammed at. Simard is out of the net. Capitals will not be able to score two goals with 3.9 left. Capitals, good job by Omaha with a lot of the shot blocks here. Late with the extra attacker for the Capitals. Capitals still need one more player out. They have the empty net. Faceoff is coming. There, so, all right, Ferrari's going to come out. Bolton will take the draw. Faceoff one back. But the Capitals suffer a 4-2 defeat. With only six games left now. The most number of points the Capitals can get. It's 32. That would give them a record that puts them right at 500. Ames is now at 500. Dubuque is at 518. Mason City is at 560. So the Caps basically have to win out Capitals tournament hopes are on life support. They need a lot of help just don't see a world where if they have a record below 500, they make it. And again, it's an extreme long shot at this juncture. Capitals are back in action. Friday, February 9th, up in Ames. Varsities plays at 7. It's a must win. It's an absolute must win. This last game, home game of the Bucks, didn't go as hoped. Now they just have to start tearing off wins. On the road. The road games continue February 17th and 18th in Kansas City. We'll do our very best to broadcast those. It won't be the easiest of places to stream from, but we will try. The Capitals are still in town on Thursday, the 22nd, to play the Oak Leafs. And then they hit the road the 24th and 25th to play the Lincoln Stars. You know, we should be able to stream without any problems from Ames and Oak Leafs. We'll find out about Lincoln. So, that does it for this 6 games this weekend. Much lighter schedule next weekend. Just the games on Friday, but we'll sign off. Thank you so much for making us a part of your early February weekend. Hope you have a good rest of your Sunday. And if you can't make it to the game in person in Ames on Friday, we hope that you'll tune in live here on YouTube. Even with this difficult defeat, I'll still leave you with a reminder, it's still a great day to be a Capital. See you from Ames.